a part of America only. When she was in the age of 5 or 6, she developed polio and lost her leg. She became crippled. All the doctors in the vicinity in one voice said, she cannot walk. She was asked by the physicians and the doctors to use crutches for executing her mobility. There is no other way for her. She was by name Wilma Rudolph. You have no other way, Wilma. You must have some sort of external device to depend upon for your mobility. You can never have a normal walk like any of your friends can have. But this girl is not prepared to accept that version. Somehow, I do not know whether she had heard any Indian sage expounding upon the true nature of man or anything like that, I do not know. But she got the true import of the Vedantic message. She was the last person to accept the version that she was crippled. She said, no, nothing has happened to me. Nothing has happened to me. Nothing can happen to me. I am all right. I will see that I will be in a position to walk like any other of my friends can. I am not going to take any crutch. I am not going to depend upon any external aid. Like any other person walks, I am going to walk. Whatever may be the strain, whatever may be the effort that I may have to put forth for achieving this, but I am bent upon, I will do it. I do achieve that, but I am not prepared to go for any other alternative. This adamantine girl was never prepared to accept any assistance or any alternative that was being suggested by the competent people around. She approached the physical education teacher one day in the school and explained her plight. Seeing the determination in her and seeing the intensity of the will that she had to restore herself the ability that she has lost presently, the teacher was very much moved, even though inside him he too was not having any hope that this girl may get back the leg that she has lost. He was prompted to tell her, don't worry Wilma, you practice walking every day sincerely for hours together. One day you will be in a position to walk. You will have a normal walk like any of your friends is having. Nothing will happen to you. Nothing is impossible for human effort. Don't worry. Only outwardly he said, but inwardly he was cocksure that nothing of like that would be any possibility any time. Because it's so evident, so glaring that she is polio hit. She can never have her feet touch the ground. So evident, but somehow that came out, blurted out in a way. She took it very seriously. From next day onwards, started practicing walking every day, both in the morning and evening, for hours together. By the time she came to the position of completing her high school education, she was the fastest girl in the school. It gave her tremendous confidence. If this much could be achieved, means I can go for further heights also. That filled her with so much of optimism. And now she is in the college studies. Similar practices she undertook there also. There came 1964 or 1960. Olympics events were to be conducted somewhere. Wilma was selected to represent America in the running race event. 100 meters running race, 200 meters running race, 400 meters running race, relay race, she got 4 gold medals. Can we ever believe this? Can we believe? Is it anything fabulous? Am I quoting anything from a fable? Or is it a reality? This is a stark reality, a glaring reality that took place in this very country only about 40 years ago. This story will give everything about the power of positive attitude, the power of positive thinking. She rebuilt herself. A new body was evolved out of the old rut. Whatever remnant that was there, that was repaired, it was thrown aside and a new body came from out of her. No person might have imagined a worse damage than that she had. It is impossible for anyone to imagine a worse condition than the condition in which she was put. But ultimately what happened? She came out triumphant. She emerged triumphant. She won over all the challenges that nature had imposed upon her. The whole world could not believe when she said, one day I'll be in a position to walk. She walked, she ran, she got gold medals, 4 gold medals in Olympics. The girl that was polio hit, who could not execute one step ahead, came to a position where she got 4 gold medals in Olympics. My friends, please ponder upon this point. How at all it came? Did she manufacture a new body and got it integrated with her old one? Where from it came? Her physical exterior was crippled, but her real inner personality, her real personality was never crippled. It is something that can never be crippled. Her real personality, her real being was not crippled.